How's it going? Today, I'm in the Fulton or Maple Lawn area of Howard County, Maryland. There's a lot going on in this house today. We've got cantilevers, we've got knee walls, we've got sloped and flat attic spaces. We're gonna do a little bit of work on the rim joist. And there's ductwork in the attic. And there's a lot of pests that were one time in this house. I'm gonna show you where they lived and things like that. So there's a lot going on in this house. All right, so I'm up in this attic in Maple Lawn, Howard County, and I just want to show you what's going on. I've already done a little bit of work on the ductwork and did some sealing, and I'm gonna do a little more. But one really interesting thing is this house was sitting vacant for just a little while, and what happened was it got infested with mice. And one of the things that I noticed when I was working on the ducts, if I can talk and get over here at the same time, is that it seemed like the mice were really setting up camp. And I think it was even further down where there were seams in the ductwork. So you can see like where there's droppings here. And if I crack it open here, I bet you I'm gonna find maybe some type of seam or some type of leakage point. I think I'll go ahead and just do that right now here. Let's see if I can. Get this a little wider here. Oh, wrong five. Yeah, okay. And what do you know? You see? You see how they align? And I just found that to be the case pretty much everywhere as I was working on these. And I'm gonna continue to do some sealing, but I also want to show you what happened when you have mice in an abandoned house. You get sort of like a food chain or like this whole ecosystem going. But that was because it was left to run rampant because the house was sitting vacant. It's not a normal thing. But what I wanted to really show is just how the mice really do take up camp where there are opportunities to increase their comfort. So where there are seams and where there's air leaking out of the nice warm ducts, that's where they're gonna set up. And I'm gonna see if I can find another example of that. Here's one here. And that's just where the ducts are mechanically fastened. And as a result, there are leakage points, and those mice are just super, super sensitive. And the dark discolored insulation really just shows like that there is leakage there, because that's what's happening. Air is flowing through and it's just acting like a filter. And the mice are just loving that. So I'm gonna go through, start working on finishing sealing these. I got my work cut out for me.
Most people call pest control when they see bugs or rodents. Today is yet another example of mice setting up camp right on top of duct insulation, directly above a leaky seam. This isn't a coincidence. It's a pattern I see all the time. If you're dealing with pests, uneven temperatures, or high energy bills, it's all connected. A home energy audit will show you where air and pests are entering, where ducts are leaking and wasting energy, and how to seal up your home to stop the problem for good. Schedule your audit today and turn your home into a sealed, efficient, pest-proof system.